Hello students, in today's class we'll discuss about RAAS and ANF mechanism. So I have got all this information in store for you. Please keep watching the entire episode. Now let us begin with our study of RAAS mechanism. RAAS mechanism makes sure that there is a normal flow of blood to kidneys and normal formation of glomerular filtration. Now whenever the blood pressure or the blood supply to kidney goes down, then RAAS mechanism makes sure that kidney gets enough blood. In order to understand this RAAS mechanism, we'll have to take a longitudinal section of nephron and understand a structure called juxtaglomerular apparatus. This tube is distal convoluted tubule. Generally, distal convoluted tubule is lined by cuboidal epithelium, whereas in this part of the DCT we have granulated tall compactly arranged cells which are called macula densa. This is efferent arteriole and this is afferent arteriole. These swollen cells, swollen smooth muscle cells lining the afferent arteriole, these are called juxtaglomerular cells. Now this tall compactly arranged columnar macula densa cells of DCT and swollen smooth muscle cells of afferent arteriole called juxtaglomerular cells together form a structure known as juxtaglomerular apparatus. Now this structure is very essential to understand how RAAS mechanism functions. Now whenever kidneys don't get enough blood, then these juxtaglomerular cells, which are swollen smooth muscle cells of afferent arteriole, they release a hormone called Renin. Now please understand, juxtaglomerular cells are the primary cells which produce and store renin. Now this renin converts a substance called angiotensinogen into angiotensin 1. Now angiotensinogen is produced by the largest gland of our body, which is liver. In the next step, this angiotensin 1 is converted into angiotensin 2. Now, how is angiotensin 1 different from angiotensin 2? Please remember, Angiotensin 1 is a decapeptide. So it is a peptide with 10 amino acids. Whereas angiotensin 2 is a octapeptide. Now, angiotensinogen is an inactive form of angiotensin, which is activated by this proteolytic enzyme called renin. Please remember here, renin is acting as proteolytic hormone in this case. Right. So, now once we have angiotensin 2, this angiotensin 2 is a powerful vasoconstrictor, which would bring about contraction of smooth muscles of blood vessels and increases the blood pressure. Now, this angiotensin 2 also stimulates a gland called adrenal gland, which is present on top of kidney. Now, this angiotensin stimulates the cortex of adrenal gland or adrenal cortex and makes it release another hormone called aldosterone. This aldosterone acts on renal tubule and brings about reabsorption of sodium. This sodium, which is reabsorbed, will cause an increase in blood pressure. So, like this, angiotensin 2 and aldosterone both increase the blood pressure and make sure that the renal artery has enough blood supply to the kidney so that kidneys can make enough urine. Now, this R in RAS mechanism stands for the first player of the mechanism, which is renin. The A, first A, stands for angiotensinogen, and the second A in the RAS mechanism stands for aldosterone. So, put together, these are three players: renin, angiotensin and aldosterone. They increase the blood pressure and make sure that kidneys get enough blood so that they can make urine. Now, this mechanism has to be regulated or else the blood pressure will keep on increasing. So, for that we have the second mechanism, which is ANF, which stands for atrial natriuretic factor. Now, as this blood pressure keeps on increasing, there is a load on auricles of heart. So, this increase in load onto the auricles of heart will make auricles release a hormone called atrial natriuretic factor or ANF. This ANF is a powerful vasodilator which would act on smooth muscles of blood vessels and bring about their relaxation. So whenever smooth muscles of blood vessels relax, the blood pressure would reduce. So this is how it brings about decrease in blood pressure. So on one hand we have a RAAS mechanism which increases the blood pressure, and on the other hand we have ANF mechanism which counters or checks the RAAS mechanism. So this is how both these mechanisms, they are very essential and control rate of formation of glomerular filtrate or ultrafiltrate. Now from NEET point of view, I would like to give you some additional information. What is the shape of cells present in macula densa? So cells of macula densa are columnar epithelium, or they are columnar in shape, whereas the rest of the cells in DCT are cuboidal in shape. The second point is, what are the types of receptors which are found in juxtaglomerular cells? On juxtaglomerular cells, we find mechanoreceptors or baroreceptors or stretch receptors. So in response to the stretch, these smooth muscle cells, swollen smooth muscle cells of afferent arteriole, they release renin. So whenever they stretch, the stretching inhibits release of renin, whereas when these cells don't stretch, that is what indicates that the blood is not flowing enough in these renal afferent renal arteriole, and that would cause release of renin. What receptors are found in cells of macula densa? So cells of macula densa have chemoreceptors. Which are sensitive to amount of sodium and other solutes. So if at all blood is not flowing enough in afferent arteriole or into glomerulus, then the rate of glomerular filtration will reduce, and whenever there is a reduced rate of glomerular filtration, then naturally the concentration of solutes in ultrafiltrate of DCT will come down. So that is what is sensed by the chemoreceptors which are present on cells of macula densa. Now which organ produces angiotensinogen? Angiotensinogen is produced by the largest gland in the body, which is liver. The next point is, please remember, renin is a proteolytic enzyme, but it acts as a hormone. So because of its proteolytic nature, it is able to cleave some of the amino acids from this proenzyme angiotensinogen and convert it into angiotensin 1. The number of amino acids in angiotensin 1 are 10, so it is called decapeptide. Whereas the number of amino acids in angiotensin 2 are 8, hence it is called octapeptide. What is the location of the hormone angiotensin converting enzyme? Please remember, angiotensin converting enzyme is what converts angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2. Now, what is the location of angiotensin converting enzyme? Please remember, ACE or angiotensin converting enzyme is located on vascular endothelium, especially in lungs. Finally, what is the difference between Renin and RENNIN? Renin. So although these two words, they sound similar, they are not same. Renin, the first renin which we have discussed today, is proteolytic enzyme which acts as hormone. Whereas the second renin is a proteolytic enzyme present in gastric juice.